Hello everyone. Today we will perform the next spectrum, that is the partition coefficient of iodine in distilled water and carbon tetrachloride. Okay. So here for the preparation or performance of this practical, we can prepare the starch paste. In this starch paste, you can take the 100 ml of warm water. Firstly, warm water we have to warm. Okay, or boil slight temperature. Then we can add in the starch 1 gram. Okay, and slowly dissolve the starch in this warm water to form a starch paste. Okay, it is acts as an indicator for the titration purpose. Then next we can prepare the 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate and 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. This is the 0.1 normal and this is the 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. Okay, it is the used for the titration. Okay, titration purpose. Then we can prepare in the stock solutions. For the preparation of stock solution, we have to prepare a 110 ml of saturated solutions of iodine in carbon tetrachloride. So 110 ml of saturated solution for making, we have to take a 55 ml iodine crystals and 55 ml carbon tetrachloride. Equal quantity or equal concentration we have to take and to form a saturated solution of iodine in carbon tetrachloride. Okay, so here this is the 55 gram of iodine crystals. We can add in the 55 ml of carbon tetrachloride. So we have to take a 55 ml carbon tetrachloride. This is the 55 ml carbon tetrachloride solution. We can add in the conical flask. In this 55 ml carbon tetrachloride, we have to add 55 gram of iodine crystals. And then we can stir the properly. This is the saturated solution of iodine in carbon tetrachloride. Okay. Then after preparing this saturated solution, we have to take a 4 separating funnels. Okay. For the preparation of 4 set. So next we have to prepare a set 4. Okay. In first set we have to take a 50 ml water, then 40 ml stock solution and remaining 10 ml CCl4. Okay. So each set containing the 50 ml water, okay, and all set containing the first set is the 40 ml stock solution, then 30 ml stock solution, then 20 ml stock solution and 10 ml stock solution, okay, and then third quantity is the 10 ml CCl4, 20 ml CCl4, then 30 ml CCl4 and 40 ml CCl4. It means we have to increasing the CCl4 quantity and decreasing the stock solution quantity. Stock solution in first set 40 ml and CCl4 10 ml. Okay, so make the 50 ml total. Okay, so prepare first is the set first. We have to take a 50 ml distilled water by using measuring cylinder. This 50 ml distilled water we have to add in the separating funnel. This 50 ml we have to add in the next separating funnel and last. 16 ml, we have to add in the last step. Okay, so these four sets add 50 ml water, distilled water. Then second step, we have to add stock solution. Okay, in first step we have to add 40 ml stock solution. This is your stock solution. Stock solution means we have to prepare a 110 ml of stock solution of iodine and carbon tetrachloride solution. So here in first set we have to add the 40 ml stock solution by using measuring cylinder. Due to presence of iodine crystal, the stock solution appear a pink color, pink purple color. Okay. This is the 40 ml stock solution we have to add in the first set. Then in second set we have to add a decreasing quantity of stock solution, that is the 30 ml stock solution. Then set 3, we have to add a 20 ml stock solution. Okay. Then in last set, we have to add a 10 ml stock solution. By using measuring cylinder. Then last step, preparation of set, that is the, we have to add a CCl4. CCl4 we can add in the increasing quantity. Okay. In first step we have to add a 10 ml CCl4. This is the 10 ml CCl4. After adding this CCl4, we have to place a stopper on the surface or knob of the separating funnel. Then in second separating funnel we have to add a 20 ml CCl4. This is the 20 ml CCl4. Is added in the set 2, and after adding it you can attach the stopper, because CCl4 it is the organic layer and it is volatile, it evaporates. Then in set 3 we have to add a 30 ml CCl4. This is 20 ml and again I have to add one. Again we have to add 10 ml. Okay. Then last step. In this step we have to add a 40 ml CCl4, highest quantity. This is 20 ml CCl4. Then I have again added 20 ml CCl4. Then we have to place the stopper on the knob of the separating funnel. Then these four sets we have to prepare. In first set, the quantity of stock solution is 40 ml and only 10 ml CCl4 we have to add. Then here is the quantity of stock solution is 30 ml, means remaining 20 ml we have to add the CCl4. Okay. Then here is the quantity of stock solution is the 20 ml, so we have to add remaining 30 ml CCl4. And here is the quantity of stock solution is the 10 ml, so remaining 40 ml we have to add the CCl4, means we have to prepare a total 50 ml CCl4 and stock solution, okay, in each set. So in these four sets, iodine crystals is present, CCl4 is present and water is present. So CCl4, it is your organic layer, water, it is your aqueous layer, and iodine, it is the drug, okay. So we have to check the iodine is distributed, we have to properly distribute the iodine crystals in the CCl4 layer and water layer. So these all sets we have to mix for 30 minutes, okay. So start the mixing of the separating funnels for 30 minutes like this. After completing this shaking, then we have to stop the shaking. After completing this 30 minutes of shaking, then next step is the, we have to stand this separating funnel for 10 minutes for the separation of two layers, that is the aqueous layer and organic layer, okay. So this top separating funnel we have to stand for the 10 minutes constantly, okay. Here we have to stop, stand the separating funnel for 10 minutes. While we have to stand this separating funnel for 10 minutes, we have to require to remove the stopper, okay. Why? Because this separation of two layers is properly occurs when we can remove the stopper, okay. So after completing this 10 minutes, we have to remove the lower aqueous layer and above organic layer is remaining in the separating funnel. So four sets below layer is the organic layer, and we have to remove the 10 ml of organic layers, okay. So we have to remove the one by one organic layers of set first. This is below the organic layer, and we can remove the by using this knob. Slowly we have to release the knob, and below organic layer is removing in the beaker. This is the intermediate layer, okay. We can discard this intermediate layer after some time. Then set 3 aqueous layer we have to remove slowly. Thank you. they set for across the other hand to remove slowly, slowly. Release the knob slowly. Only organic layer is remaining. Okay, like this set, we have to remove the intermediate layer of set second. Only organic layer is remaining. Then set, you have to remove the intermediate layer of the set. Okay. And then last set. Here also we have to remove the intermediate layer. Okay. Then in the next step, we have to perform the titration. For performance of the titration, aqueous layer titrate against the 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate. Set first, aqueous layer we have to take, and then in the conical flask we have to add the 10 ml aqueous layer of set first. Okay. By using pipette, measure the 10 ml of aqueous layer of set first. Up to layer of set 1, okay. Titration is completed when this purple color is disappear, okay. This is your end point. At the starting of titration process, purple color is purple color of the solution. But after completing this titration, or when 25 ml reading is noted, we can note down, because at 25 ml the color of the solution or aqueous layer is changing. That is, the purple color is disappear. Okay, so we have to note down the end point or end reading. Okay, that is the 25 ml for set 1. So we have to again perform the titration of second set of aqueous layer. Okay, same the set of first aqueous layer. 10 ml solution we have to take by using the pipette. Okay, this is the 10 ml aqueous layer of set 2. Then in this 10 ml set 2, we have to add a starch indicator, 1 to 2 drops. One dropper. Okay. Then again titration is start. Before titration is start, again this burette is filled with 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Then start the titration of set 2 aqueous layer. Slowly, slowly add the 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate solution and continuously shaking the conical flask until the purple color is disappear totally. Purple color is disappear at 27 reading, means this solution consuming the 27 ml of sodium thiosulfate solution to change their color, or purple color is disappear. Okay, same like this we have to perform the titration of set 3 aqueous layer. Take the 10 ml of aqueous layer by using pipette. Then in this 10 ml solution, add 1 to 2 drops of starch indicator. And then again, fill the burette with 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Okay. Then start the titration process. color is the color is disappear. See here, purple color is totally disappear and yellowish color is appear. Okay, so purple color is disappear means it is your end point. Means 20 ml sodium thiosulfate consuming the set 3 of the aqueous layer. Okay, then like this say last titration we have to perform, that is the aqueous layer of set 4. Again take this aqueous layer of set 4 and measure the 10 ml of aqueous layer by using pipette. Then add in this solution 1 to 2 drops of starch indicator. Disappear and the solution is clear. Okay, it means your end point is the 23 ml. Okay, means 23 ml sodium thiosulfate solution is consuming this solution, aqueous solution, and the pink or purple color is totally disappear and clear color is formed. Okay, this is your end point reading. Okay, then like this we have to perform the titration of organic layer. Okay, this titration is the aqueous layer and next is the titration of organic layer. In set first, second, third and fourth. First set of the organic layer in the conical flask, 10 ml of set first we have to take. This 10 ml we have to remove by using pipette. First pipette is clean by water and then we have to take a 10 ml of organic layer from separating funnel and add this organic layer in the conical flask. Here is the difference. We have to titration against 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. For aqueous layer we have to titrate the 0.01 normal sodium thiosulfate solution, and here for the organic layer we have to titrate the only 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Okay, so fill the burette with 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Stop the titration process. Okay, 12 is a totally disappear color. So the 8 point of your reading is the 9 ml. Means 9 ml 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate is consuming this solution. Okay. Then again we have to start the titration of step 2. For this purpose we have to measure the 10 ml of organic air.